authorities are warning of a heat apocalypse.
They say it is apocalyptic heat.
From one side of the continent to the other, Europe burns. Its record-breaking heat wave showing no sign of letting up, with temperatures overnight hitting the 40s from Greece in the east to France in the west.
When will this end? Possibly not until middle of next week. And again, continued high temperatures for most of Europe.
Across Greece and Italy, out-of-control blazes. In France, nearly 37,000 people have been evacuated near Bordeaux as a 190-square-kilometre fire continues to rage.
Today is a very critical day. We don't know at the moment which direction it will take.
Also battling wildfires, Portugal and Spain, where the heatwave has killed more than 1,000 people. This farmer now fighting for his life after fleeing the flames.
He is well known in the town, and the poor man got hurt as he was just trying to help.
And now the UK is feeling the heat.
We've got plenty of fluids, as you can tell. And coming down here and getting the spray off the fountain, which has been great.
I mean, there is sweat running down everybody's backs, and it's quite the cue. But it's hot.
Sweltering through the hottest temperatures on record, the mercury peaking at 40.3 degrees for the first time in history as roads melt and train tracks buckle. The searing conditions sparking fires across London and its outskirts.
And suddenly it just ignited. It was just unbelievable how it exploded.
Firefighters struggling to keep on top of the chaos.
Some of the fires today have required more than 30 fire engines, some have required 20 fire engines, some have required 15 fire engines. It's simply not possible for the London Fire Brigade to respond to all of these fires if they continue at this pace.
And as the heatwave rages, fears rise that this unprecedented weather could be a grim window into the future.
It's a consequence of climate change. These sort of fires we're seeing today could become the norm rather than the exception.
I hope that these kind of events are going to be a wake-up for many governments, and these kind of events will have an impact on voting behaviour.
Latika Bourke is sweating her socks off in London, and she joins us now. Latika, Australians, including you, would be familiar with 40-degree days, but is it a different thing to experience over there?
Yeah, definitely. I think one of the hottest days I ever lived was in 2006, the summer of 2006. I feel like Bryan Adams there, in Western Sydney in Castle Hill. And it was 45 degrees, and I remember being in a friend's pool, but at 45 degrees, the water was just a warm bath. And it was the same feeling yesterday here in London, and it's the first time I've ever felt it here in the UK or really in Europe, where the heat is so hot, it's inescapable. And no matter what you do or how you try to get cool, sometimes the act of trying to get cool just makes you hotter. So, for example, in the UK, there's really not a lot of air conditioning around, and we don't have a lot of big shopping malls. That's not really a thing in the UK. The high streets are all small shops. So even if you wanted to try and go and park yourself in a shopping centre for the day, getting on the tube where the actual temperatures are about 5 to 7 degrees hotter, or on the bus, which I got on yesterday, I cannot even begin to describe. I mean, my face was dripping with sweat. I would look down and it was on my clothes. It's disgusting.
You mentioned, you paint quite a picture there, Latika. You mentioned your experiences, you know, in Castle Hill back in Australia. As an Aussie, are you giving the Brits, are you telling war stories? Are you giving them advice of how to get through this?
No, I actually think it's really bad when Australians mock and laugh at the British for being a bit soft and not being able to control these temperatures. It's really different to live in 40 degrees plus. In fact, I think it's really hard any time the temperature goes above 35, because London is a city that's built to trap heat. You know, it was built for cold temperatures. So you have buildings which absorb the heat, and once they heat up, stay warm, which is great in winter. But in the summer, that's just absolutely horrific. My poor cat yesterday, she's really resilient, grew up in Australia. She knows what hot weather is like. It's first day I've ever seen her just lie under furniture all day, wouldn't move, wouldn't talk to me. In the end, I put a damp towel on her, and that would normally get me kind of some paw swipes. Nothing. Just didn't move, just accepted the cold towel on her. I mean, that's how hot it is. When you look at your pets and they're struggling, you know it's really, really hard.
Well, there have also been fires in and around London, which you don't usually see. Are the fire service equipped to know how to deal with this level of fires?
Well, yesterday the London Fire Brigade got around 2,500 call-outs. They would normally get around 400 to 500 in a single day. So that gives you some perspective about the scale of the task ahead of emergency responders if this is a new normal for Britain, which all the data says this is what we're heading for.
Latika, thank you very much for sharing your perspectives and also those of your cat.
Thanks, guys.